Hey there, Star Wars fans, and welcome back to another episode of Astromech Productions, a Star Wars and LEGO Star Wars YouTube channel. The Star Wars galaxy is full of a vast array of wondrous creatures, some small, some large, some furry, some scaly, some humanoid, some reptilian, some force sensitive, and some not. Now, we don't actually know how many species there are in the Star Wars galaxy, but there are a few million on Earth, so we can estimate a couple of octillion in the vastness of the galaxy. And amongst those are force sensitives of every type. Today, I'll be counting down the top 10 most force sensitive species in the galaxy, starting with the least force sensitive on the list and ending with the most. These species will all be classed as sentient and canon. However, I will be including Legends content for species where there is little canon information, but these will all be things that I would feel would make perfect sense as canon. Let's jump straight into it. The first species on this list is the Rhodian species. Rhodians are reptilian humanoid species from the planet Rhodia. They usually had scaly green skin, but sometimes it was yellow or turquoise. One distinctive feature of the Rhodian was their large pupilless eyes, which often appeared to be full of stars, allowing them to see in the infrared spectrum. Though Rhodians were primarily oxygen breathers, their lungs could adapt to a great many atmospheres. Rhodia was a swampy jungle planet in the Outer Rim, described by Luke Skywalker as having a distinct and pungent odour. Though this species originally inhabited the swamps of their homeworld, by the time we first encounter Rhodia in the Clone Wars TV show, they've been living in cities raised above the ground covered in glass domes for several hundred years. Rhodians were often given a bad reputation by many of the galaxy, due to a large number of them being bounty hunters, most notably Greedo. However, many Rhodians were force sensitive, and as a result joined the Jedi Order. Famous Rhodian Jedi include Ganodi, Bolo Rapal, and twi’lek, the only canon Jedi apart from Mace Windu to wield a purple bladed lightsaber. The ninth most force sensitive species in the galaxy was the Saurian species. The Saurians were a sentient humanoid species from the planets Sauria. The largest distinction between humans and Saurians is the Saurian's conical head shape. This head actually contained two brains, allowing high levels of intelligence and a prowess at problem solving. It was said that the Saurians could debate arguments in their head, using each brain to form each side of the argument. Due to these two brains, Saurians also required two hearts to allow enough oxygen to reach both. Although the Saurians were an advanced species due to their increased intelligence, their homeworld of Sauria remained largely untouched by technology, giving the Saurians a strong connection with the beautiful nature on their planet. Saurians were generally regarded as a noble and caring species, an image probably helped by the large number of them in the Jedi Order, though Saurian crime lords were not unheard of, such as the criminal Su Tath. Saurian females vastly outnumbered the males 20 to 1, meaning that Saurians had a very low birth rate, so polygamy was essential for the survival of the species. Also, Saurian male Jedi Knights, such as Kaidi Mundi, were allowed by the Jedi Order to have wives and families to ensure the continuation of their species. Some notable force-sensitive Saurians were Jedi Master Kaidi Mundi and the youngling Omer. The next species here is the Tagut species. These were a sentient species from the planet Shili. They were distinguished by their colourful skin tones, two large mantles, three head tails, and facial pigments. The coloration of their skin and head tails helped them to camouflage in the grasses of their homeworld. A Tagut's mantles were hollow, giving them a form of echolocation. Although the Tagut's originally came from Shili, a colony of around 50,000 lived on the planet Krios. They had a strong connection with their planet, meaning that many did not wear shoes to constantly be in touch with it. It was this, and their heightened senses, that meant many Tagut's were force sensitive. Most famously, Ahsoka Tano, Shark T, and Ashla. The seventh most force-sensitive species in the galaxy was the Keldor species. These were sentient, near-humanoids from the planet Doran. They had thick, rubbery skin that ranged in colour from peach to crimson red. Keldors could not breathe in oxygen-rich atmospheres, so had to wear breath masks when off-world. They also wore eye goggles to stop their eye fluids evaporating. Due to their masks and skin, Keldors could survive in space for a short amount of time. The eyes of a Keldor were usually black, however, Force-sensitive Keldors were often born with silver irises. Force sensitivity was highly respected amongst the Keldors. The Baron Doe, a council of Force sensitives, helped lead their society as advisors. However, they faded out of existence once Doran joined the Republic, and Force-sensitive Keldors were taken into the Jedi Order. Plo Koon was one Keldor Jedi. The twi’lek, or Rolossian species, is the next species on my list. These were a race of sentient, near-humanoids from the outer rim planet of Ryloth. The most prominent feature of the twi’lek was their head tails, or leku. Twi’leks usually had two leku, though some did have four, and they were often used in the twi’lek language of twi’leki. Twi’leks came in a vast array of colours, including white, orange, yellow, green, pink, blue, purple, black, and red. Twi’leks also had a very distinctive accent when they spoke Galactic Basic, but it was possible to lose this accent if they were away from Ryloth for long enough, though it could re-emerge if they returned. Twi’lek women were considered very beautiful, and as a result, were often sold into slavery in the crime syndicates. Ryloth was also subject to some very brutal occupations, such as the Separatist and Imperial rules, due to its precious natural resources. This caused the creation of the Ryloth Resistance during the Clone Wars and the Free Ryloth Movement during the Imperial era, both led by Champs and Jula. Force sensitivity was high amongst the Twi’leks, and they were a common sight in the Jedi Temple. Twi’lek Jedi include Aayla Secura, Finn Erte, and Halon Quintu. The fifth most Force-sensitive species in the galaxy was the human species. Humans were by far the most prevalent species in the galaxy, with some living on almost every known planet. It is believed that humans originated from Coruscant, but this is disputed. I won't go into much more detail about humans, as we should all know what they look like and how they function as a society. Due to the vast number of humans in the galaxy, they were by far the most prevalent species in the Jedi Order. Famous Force-sensitive humans include Anakin Skywalker, Obi-Wan Kenobi, Mace Windu, Darth Sidious, and Count Dooku. The next species is the Zabrak species. These were sentient humanoid species from Iridonia, however, there was a small colony on Dathomir. Iridonian Zabrak skin ranged from very light to very dark tones, however, Dathomirian Zabraks were generally red, yellow, or orange. They both had facial tattoos which indicated their family and their personality. Both species of Zabraks also had a ring of horns on their head, with male horns being larger than female. Some Iridonian Zabraks also had hair, which was either black, dark blue, or purple. Zabraks had a strong sense of self and independence. This was viewed by most of the galaxy as sheer arrogance, but it was an important part of their culture. Due to this, Zabraks greatly resisted occupation, with many joining the Rebel Alliance and later the Resistance. Many Zabraks were also bounty hunters, mercenaries or spies, jobs that required a lot of use of one's own physical and mental skills. Famous Zabrak Force sensitives include Agen Kolar, Eeth Koth, Darth Maul and Savage Opress. The third most Force-sensitive species in the galaxy was the Bardotan species, which was sentient reptilian species from the planet Bardota, but there was also a large colony on Thu and many smaller ones around the rest of the galaxy. Bardotan skin came in a variety of colours, including green, grey, blue, red, orange and yellow, and some had mottled skin with distinctive markings of several colours. Bardotans had three-toed hoof-like feet and four-fingered hands. Atop their long, curved necks sat a pointed skull with a large beak, giving them a similar appearance to ducks. The largest variation between Bardotans was their height, with some being only a metre tall at full maturity, and some being around 2 metres. Bardotans always had a rich, force-based culture. In their early society, they were warrior people, led by the Frangol cult, and worshipped demons such as Marmor. However, the Dagoran Order soon gained popularity and power, and banned the Frangol religion. However, it did make a revival during the Clone Wars. The Dagoran Order represented the religious side of the planet, whilst the power was held by the Bakhtov Council and the reigning monarch. However, they were all masters of the Dagoran Order. All schooling on the planet was also run by the Dagorans, but belief in the religion was not mandatory. The Dagoran Order focused on intellect and the arts through the Force. Because of this, a great many Bardotans were Force-sensitive or had a strong connection to the Force. There were no Bardotan Jedi, as the few times they did try to induct Bardotan children into the Order, they were branded as kidnappers and not allowed back. The second most Force-sensitive species in the galaxy is Yoda's species. This is a species that we know virtually nothing about. We don't even know their actual name. However, it is widely speculated that we will learn more about them in the second season of The Mandalorian. Members of the species were rarely seen in the galaxy. There were two known genders, male and female, both of which looked roughly similar. The species were approximately the size of a young human child of about 8 or 9 years old when fully grown. They had green skin that darkened until maturity and then became lighter as they grew older again. Their long pointed ears were often used to show emotions. This species had a mostly carnivorous diet, eating mainly amphibians, but they did eat some fruit and vegetables. They could have hair, but the only known colours were white and auburn. The species aged very slowly, still being in the early stages of infancy at 50 years old, and only reaching full maturity at 100. The only recorded examples of Force-sensitive members of this species are Yoda, Yaddle, and the Child, who are also the only recorded members of the entire species. The final species on my list, and most Force-sensitive in the galaxy, is the Wands. The Wands were the embodiment of the different variants of the Force. There were three of them: the Son, who embodied the dark side, the Daughter, who embodied the light, and the Father, who embodied total balance. The Wands lived on the planet of Mortis and were immortal, but they could be killed by the Dagger of Mortis, or if the Father died, he could die of old age after millions of years, as we saw in the Clone Wars Season 3. The Son and Daughter would lose most of their power and could be killed by normal weapons. They had no exact form, but the Father generally appeared as an old man with a long grey beard and grey robes and hat. The Daughter usually appeared as a young woman with green hair and white and gold robes, and the Son was generally a young man with red markings on his white face and black and red robes. It is speculated that the Force itself originated from them. They were all killed in the second year of the Clone Wars. Okay guys, that's it for the top 10 most naturally Force-sensitive species in the Star Wars galaxy. Tell me in the comments which species was your favourite, or if there are any that you were surprised to see in the top 10. May the Force be with you, and I'll see you next time on Astromech Productions.